Hello everyone, this is Accelerate Games. I am back with another episode of Let's Play for Fallout 4. I am playing it on the hardest difficulty, so it is a bit challenging, so sometimes if I'm not as talkative, it's because I'm concentrating. So let's hop right back in.
Intruder. Contact detected. Possibly Kellogg has ordered your termination. It would appear my target has disappeared. Present.
is under Institute authority. Terminating intruder. Possibly.
Detected. I have detected. Visit my old friend, the frozen TV dinner. Last time we met, you were cozying up to the peas and apple cobbler. City. After that, figured the Commonwealth would chew you up like jerky.
Engaging hostile life form.
Thank you. pissed off, I get it, I do. But whatever you hope to accomplish in here, it's not gonna go your way.
Hostile.
You got guts and determination. It's admirable. You are in over your head in ways you can't possibly comprehend.
You must die. Thank you.
Got it.
Okay. You made it. I'm just up ahead. My synths are standing down. Let's talk.
Let's talk. You murdered my wife. Took my son. You're a dead man.
Your wife. That was a regrettable accident. Still, this world, this life, you've seen it. Pain, suffering. Death is its only escape. Don't worry. Sean's fine. Maybe a little older than you expected, huh? But I can't give him to you. Because he ain't here.
Fuck you, Kellogg.
Let him go. Your time's done. Your son is exactly where he belongs. He's home. In the Institute.
No! That's not true. It can't be. I've come so far.
Yes. You have. And believe it or not, I'm actually kind of sorry you wasted your time. In another life, you probably would have been a good father. But here, in this terrible reality, you just don't get that chance. But I think we've been talking long enough. We both know how this has to end. So, you ready?
You know, in 100 years, when I finally die, I only hope I go to hell so I can kill you all over again, you piece of shit.
Is someone present?
You know, in 100 years, when I finally die, I only hope I go to hell so I can kill.
Thank you.
All this tech, you were barely human.
Hey.
People of the Commonwealth, do not interfere. Our intentions are peaceful. We are the Brotherhood of Steel.
Nikki, I'm just asking for your opinion. It'd be a great quote.
He's my client, Piper. Why don't you learn not to snoop on a man's private affairs?
Well, well, speak of the devil.
You're back. And not with your son. What happened?
This is your fault, Nick.
You had me running all over the place while Kellogg was busy handing Sean over to the Institute.
The Institute? Oh, boy.
I'm sorry, friend. Truly. That makes things considerably more complicated.
He ain't kidding. Heck, Nick's a synth, and even he doesn't know how to get in.
No synth does. Security protocols strip those memories out.
No, oh, Mr. Metal for Hands doesn't know how to get back to the factory.
No, I skipped that part of the orientation film while they were busy pulling me apart and putting me back together again. Look, the sad thing is, I have no idea.
I've been investigating these creeps for over a year now. The Commonwealth's boogeyman. Feared and hated by everyone.
True enough.
Sometimes they snatch people in the middle of the night. And sometimes they leave old synths behind to remind us that they're out there. But to this day, there's one thing nobody really knows.
Where the Institute actually is. Or how to get in.
Exactly. But there's one person who has to know, right? The guy who just handed them Sean.
Kellogg. Huh.
Whatever you're thinking, it doesn't matter. He's dead.
Yeah. Figures the Institute's only man on the outside wouldn't be the type to be taken alive.
So, a murderer and a kidnapper gets his brains blown out by an avenging parent. Huh. Be a great ending if we didn't still have the biggest mystery in the Commonwealth to solve. You're standing there with your...
Doesn't matter what he knew. I'd kill him again in a heartbeat.
Gets his brains blown out. Huh. His brains. You know, we may not need the man at all.
You're talking crazy here, Nick. Got a fault in the old subroutines?
Look, there's a place in Good Neighbor called the Memory Den. Relive the past moments in your mind as clear as the day they happened. If anyone could get a dead brain to sing, it'll be Dr. Amari, the mind behind the memories.
There's no way that could ever work.
Stay with me on this. We get a piece of Kellogg's gray matter and take it to Amari. Then we see if she's got the goods to pull this off.
Jesus, Nick. Gross. Seriously?
I know it's grisly, but what choice do we have? We got no leads. Nothing. That old Merc's brain just might have all the secrets we need to know.
I'm gonna need a really sharp ice cream scoop.
I'm sure you'll manage.
Whether we're riding this crazy brain train or not, we can't all go running across the Commonwealth, so who's coming with you?
I have to go to the Memory Den either way, if I'm going to introduce you to Amari. But if you want to head there together, just say so.
Anything else you can tell me about the Memory Den?
It's in Good Neighbor, a little slice of trouble northeast a ways. The Memory Den ain't just a fancy name. It's literal. A lot of people give up all their caps just to relive the good parts of their lives. Over and over. But not us. We're gonna try to dive deep into someone else's mind. I can meet you there or we can head out together.
I'll head out with Piper. We'll meet you there, Nick.
Sounds good. You two stay out of trouble. Don't worry. We're gonna get your boy back. Just a few more steps.
And by the way, at some point, you owe me an interview. I want want to hear how this whole story got started.